Christian and Roden Carlo Lizardo from the Institute of Weed Science, Entomology, and Plant Pathology. So take it away, sir.
Okay, good morning, everyone. Our next speaker is the former director of the Crop Science Cluster and the longtime head of the UPLB CAF's Rice Varietal Improvement Program. So may I call on Dr.
I was ordered by the dean. No, I was just joking. Buwabaway ako kasi sir, kahapon inano ako niyan eh. Oh, nagtitinaraw ako. Totoo naman. So, maraming salamat at I will discuss our humble contribution to rice food security in the country. Kasi ngayon ay may controversy sa NFA rice. Sabi ng DA, wala namang shortage ng rice. Anyway, ito yung background. This program is, by the way, before I start, kung may tanong kayo mamaya, I have brought with me our team members. Ano kayo? Pakitaas yung mga from senior to the youngest. Kami ni Prof. Borromeo, ako, si Danny ay considered senior na. Yung mga angels doon, mga ano yon, mga new blood na magte-take over sa iyo. Before I start, I would like to acknowledge the help as well as the support of the UPLB administration since the start of or since the time of Chancellor Villarreal for supporting our rice program. Kahit naghihingalo noon ay tuloy pa rin ang hindi kami tinatanggalan ng tao. Kaya yun ang dahilan kung bakit we have continuous production or development of varieties since 1950s, as indicated here. This is a collaborative program of researchers from various disciplines of College of Agriculture and Food Science and College of Human Ecology, spanning 6 decades. So mga 1950s pa ito, at ito siguro ang pinakamatagal kasabay ng corn program, rice and corn dati. So researchers on varietal improvement and technology development, also this program, we are training undergraduate and graduate students majoring in plant breeding, crop physiology and agronomy. Yung mga na-train natin dito, isa sa mga na-train natin dito, yung present director ng PhilRice, Dr. Sailila, he was my student. And yung mga foreign students, si Tintut, sa Myanmar, saka sa Thailand, yung director ng parang quality assurance nila, dating estudyante ko, ay na-expose rice breeding din dito sa Philippines. So active involvement in the Rice Varietal Improvement Group of the National Seed Industry Council. As of now, I'm Prof. Borromeo and myself are members of the Technical Working Group. And by the way, I would like also to acknowledge the contribution of yung mga dating members dito. Alam ko si Dr. Villarreal ay naging part din ng rice breeding dati. Si Dr. Yung tiyo ko, si Dr. Escuro, si Dr. Masaho, then si Dr. Edwin Javier, saka si Dr. Ramirez, our national scientist, dating boss ni Tess, Dr. Mabayad, now mayroon na akong pakikitang picture later on sa mga ibang team na presently involved dito sa breeding. So the objectives, these are general objectives kasi mahirap yung mga specific objectives namin: to develop sustainable and climate change adaptive farming technologies through rice varietal improvement, integrated crop management, enhance agricultural innovation through the participatory development of integrated rice-based agricultural system involving rice breeding, pest management, nutrient and water management, and within the context of integrated rice-based production to enhance community participation in local governance and decision-making. Ito yung current research activities namin. We have 9 major projects, activities, from rice germplasm to NCT. Yung 4 dito ay development of rice cultivars for rain-fed lowland drought-prone, supported by DABAR. Improved resource-use efficient rice varieties for the Philippines, in collaboration with IRI, supported by Picard, DOST. Yung National Multi-Environment Testing of Drought-Prone Direct-Seeded Rice, supported by DABAR again. Then itong improvement of Azucena rice variety by mutation breeding under the basic research of UPLB. And then development of thermosensitive genetic male sterile lines in collaboration with Field Rice and also the NCT. So first, let me describe the activities of the rice genetic resources conservation. We are maintaining sizable working collection for use by breeders, researchers, farmers, and other interested individuals here at UPLB. We store this. This program has assembled accession of traditional varieties and wild species collected throughout the country, and we have more than 800 accessions of Philippine traditional rice varieties stored at our short-term cold storage facility at Field Rice, Los Baños. We have this wild rice species that were collected by the group of Prof. Borromeo. We have Oryza rufipogon, Oryza meyeriana, Oryza officinalis, and Oryza minuta. And we use this in interspecific crosses to broaden the genetic base of our rice breeding and to provide breeders with semi-improved germplasm. We've used Oryza rufipogon, Oryza longistaminata, and Oryza barti. This species have AA genome, kaya pwede silang mag-cross with the cultivated rice. And in our rain-fed rice breeding, our aim is to develop improved rice varieties suitable to rain-fed drought-prone environments with resistance to major pests and diseases and good eating and grain qualities. So nagsisimula sa identification ng parents, and then, by the way, ito yung flowchart. I will not discuss the details here, but yung activities ng mga breeders ay itong nasa gitna. Yung mga kasama namin sa screening, grain quality, ay involved sila sa identification of parents and also dito sa pag-screen nung mga lines, even in the later advanced generation F6 or F7, then preliminary yield trial, NCT, saka varietal recommendation. Usually, the average duration from hybridization to release is 10 years. Kaya ganun ka tagal. So may pre-breeding activities din kami, wide hybridization, saka mutation, and we are starting use of molecular tools. And we have participatory breeding sa sites Lopez and Batangas. And then with the group of Dr. Masao here at Field Rice Los Baños, we are also collaborating on the development of hybrid TGMS varieties. So ito yung product ng rain-fed rice breeding na na-release for the past 5 years. So mayroon tayong NSIC RC 7276 or Sahod Ulan 4, NSIC RC 282 or Sahod Ulan 7, and NSIC RC 286 or Sahod Ulan 9. By the way, ang breeder natin dito ay si Danny, at we acknowledge the significant contribution of Mr. Danny Lalikan on the development of this 7 varieties. Itong dalawa ay hindi pa pinapangalanan. We will name this coming March, kasi may meeting yung technical secretariat, may meeting sa March. Kaya kailangan yung data dito para ma-recommend na for national release. So ito yung mga na-release natin. NSIC RC 419 or Sahod Ulan 14, and NSIC RC 476 or Sahod Ulan 24. And ito yung dalawa ay wala pang pangalan. Also, we have collaborative work with Field Rice. Ito yung TGMS-based two-line hybrid breeding. Anong kaibahan ng TGMS compared sa... Kasi mayroon na tayong more than 50 hybrids na three-line hybrids. Yung three-line hybrids, kailangan ng three components. Yung CMS or A-line, then maintainer B-line, saka yung restorer. Dito sa TGMS, two-line, kaya two-line ito dahil sa hindi kailangan yung maintainer. So you need only 30 degrees centigrade to 24 degrees day-night temperature for you to have sterile line, and yung para ma-maintain yung fertility, you need 24 to 16 degrees centigrade day and night temperature. And we are involved in the development of TGMS hybrids. Sorry. Ito yung flowchart ng development ng TGMS hybrids, from assembly and evaluation to test performance of TGMS lines as parents. Then ito rin yung pag nag-identify na tayo ng potential hybrids, naka-generate tayo ng crosses, this will be evaluated in the field, and we will have observational yield trial, preliminary yield trial, and advanced yield trial, and ultimately kung maganda sa NCT. So ito yung na-develop natin in collaboration with Field Rice, Mestizo 19 and 20. Ito ay ginogrow na ng mga farmers natin all over the Philippines. Itong Mestizo 273 ay na-release lang last year. So as of the present, we have more than, from 1963 to the present, we have more than 40 varieties released for the Philippines. So sa mutation breeding, ito yung ginawa natin. We've selected traditional varieties, were subjected to Cobalt 60. And ito yung mga traditional varieties na sinubject natin sa Azucena, Pirurutong, Binatang, Palawan. And the goal is to shorten days to maturity and plant stature and increase tillering. And as of now, we are evaluating more than 400 lines, M5 lines in the field. So ito yung mga aberrant phenotypes na na-observe namin sa field. Itong albinism, yung abnormal panicles, and yung profuse tillering. And dun sa study ng kasama namin, ang napansin namin ay, yung from 200 to 400 GY or parang dose ay may nakuha kaming mutant. Pero pag 600 to 1,000 GY na, patay na sila lahat. So, in collaboration with the group of Dr. Ali Sairi, more than 70 IRO lines or improved resource use efficient lines are evaluated for nutrient and water use efficiency to identify cost-efficient rice lines for the rain-fed ecosystem. As of last week, we visited our sites in Quezon, Lopez Quezon, and Pamplona Camarines Sur, and usually we involve the farmers in the field so that they can give us some feedback as to their preferred varieties. Also, for technology extension, we train partners and collaborators on participatory breeding and other that can help them on their activities. Kung naalala ninyo, retired na rin itong si Fred Sinuhin, Dr. Fred Sinuhin sa IWEP, at nagle-lecture siya on identification and proper control of some major diseases. So, future of the program is gearing towards the application of modern research tools in the conduct of its activities. We are yung rapid generation advance, marami ng modification, mayroon ng through sa IRI, yung ginagamit nila ay mayroon silang bagong facilities on RGA and also on speed breeding, yung lighting ay nabisita ni na Dean sa Australia, pero mas kaya inano namin ito yung by the way, ito yung mga kasama namin sa grupo, wala ata si na Esther saka si Fe. Wala dito sa hall. Nandito si Director Pompe, si hindi naman yung buhok ko itim pa eh. Si Bong pero nagpapayaman sa Saipan. So ito si Danny, si Senen na nag-retire na rin 2 years ago. So si Ningning sa food science, hindi food science, sa human ecology, in charge of our grain quality group. At ito yung dalawang natin magte-take over sa amin. Saka yung wala dito yung mga project staff namin na hindi pa sila on board nung kunin itong picture na ito. So maraming salamat, at kung may tanong kayo din, nandiyan yung mga kasama ko sa tabi.
Thank you very much, sir. We are allowed like 10 minutes. Questions or clarifications for Dr. Hernandez?
Okay. Ano sekreto mo sa buhok? Mamaya, mag-usap tayo. Yung
Myanmar ni Romel, makukunahan tayo naman sa...
Well, I'm about to say that. Kasi, well, Myanmar is also a big country, you know, pero it's still starting to for that. Kasi in the early 50s, 60s, silang number one rice importer.